Rockstar has made many games based around crime in the course of its history. However, you've always found yourself playing as the criminal instead of on the side of the law. As of May 17th, 2011, this is no longer the case.
LAPD, could we have a word?
Case you never solve. The one that keeps you awake at night.
You shot a man in cold blood.
Takes a certain animal cunning, lad. Do you think you might be ready for that?
What have we got?
Two stiffs, overdosed. The victim was dead before the car hit him.
Spill it, or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of you. You needed the money, so you killed her.
That's not true, goddammit!
I thought you'd been under fire before. So I'm supposed to believe that you don't know what happened?
I expect you to draw your own conclusions.
Not gonna happen, fellas.
This is your chance.
Don't fail me.
L.A. Noire takes place in post-World War II Los Angeles. You play as Cole Phelps, a returning war veteran who gets a job at the Los Angeles Police Department as a detective. You're tasked with investigating crimes such as traffic cases, homicide, arson, etc. Along the way, you follow the main narrative, which spans the length of the game.
Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram!
L.A. Noire is an open-world game, however, cases are solved in a linear fashion. First, you drive to the crime scene. Then you search the area for evidence that can help give you leads to who committed the crime.
The victim's bag? Looks brand new. Can't be the one used on the body.
The clues in L.A. Noire are extremely detailed and well created. A few of them even include short minigames which you need to complete before you get the clue. These are an extremely good addition because it mixes up the experience and keeps the pacing interesting, since you'll be finding a lot of clues over the course of the game. After that, you interview various witnesses around the crime, as well as other people of interest. The way the interviews work is unlike anything you've ever seen before. Rockstar is using a brand new facial capture technology. With this, the facial expressions of the voice actors can be portrayed on the in-game characters in extreme detail. So much detail that you're able to tell if the suspect is lying. After each one of their responses to your questions, you're given three options. You can believe them, doubt them, or say that they're lying. However, in the case of a lie, you must have evidence to prove it. I think the interviews are great because they require you to think very hard about what you're going to say. You need to review the evidence, look for uneasiness in the people's faces, and remember what was previously said during that conversation. The amount of evidence you get out of each conversation is directly dependent on how many questions you get right, so it's possible to miss some vital clues if you perform poorly. One issue I have with the conversation system is that, when you choose doubt, you're basically just saying they're lying without having any proof. The responses you get from choosing lie or doubt are too closely related. I think it would have been better that, instead of doubt, they added an option such as further investigate, where you could continue to ask the subject about whatever they were talking about. Conversations work well, but I think they should have been refined a little bit more. In between sections of the case, or when you're arresting a suspect, the game usually throws in some action sequences. In gunfights, the game plays like a standard third-person cover-based shooter. There aren't any problems with the shootouts, but that's because they don't really have many components to start with. Chasing the suspect, both in a car and on foot, is another very common occurrence. Both the chases work well, but I find that the ground ones are a lot more fun. They're hectic and usually take you to some pretty diverse locations, like sometimes even to the rooftops of the city. I would certainly not recommend this game solely for its action sequences, since they're very bland and extremely repetitive. However, taken as a whole, they do offer a nice break from the intellectual case-solving side.
God damn it! I said cough it up! I'm not gonna say it again.
Say for Gaia! Come on, yeah!
That's it, old man. I've had enough of your gibberish.
L.A. Noire is definitely one of the most unique games I've played in a long time. Investigations are complicated and satisfying to complete. The story is focused on characters as opposed to set-piece cinematic moments.
Since when have the police cared about dead black men?
Good point. We don't. What we care about is 2 tons of army surplus morphine showing up on the street.
And last but not least, maintains a solid experience throughout the course of the game. L.A. Noire is not perfect, and certainly not going to be appreciated by everyone, but if you're somebody who wants a game that emphasizes brains over brawn, then L.A. Noire is a great choice to look into.
It You read this story in the Examiner about the Navy developing three-dimensional movies?
What's a dimension?
You know, like a graph. Vertical axis is Y and horizontal is X.
Well, that's clear as mud.
Third dimension would be Z. So things would be popping out of the screen.
That's ridiculous. Scare people out of the theater.
God's name would want that. I don't know. People scoffed at the idea of talking using color. Look what we have now.